on a couple of stocks and an NIIT. That's the stock on our radar today. We have Mr. Sapnesh Lalla, the CEO of the company, who joins us to discuss the impact of this rupee depreciation. What's the outlook for FY19? Hi, Mr. Lalla. Thanks so much, sir, for joining in. Well, the US and the UK, they account for roughly around 70% of the revenues. Do you expect any impact of cross-currency moves, or are you mostly hedged?
I think from a hedging perspective, we are more or less automatically hedged because a fair part of our headcount is based out of developed markets, both in Europe as well as in US. So we have a natural hedge. With respect to the currency, I think we'll see an uplift. However, as you probably are aware, we take currency exchange rates as of the first of the month, and so you might not see as strong a dollar in our numbers as it is today, but it would reflect some uplift.
Okay. Sapnesh, good morning. Talking about business then, at the end of Q1, you had a corporate learning visibility of about $224 million and 49 managed training services, or MTS customers, as you called it. Where do those numbers stand?
We are pretty close to our quarterly results, so I would not talk about what's happened during this quarter, but I would say that we've had some strong activity in terms of closing new managed training services customers, and we will talk a little bit more about it in specifics as we talk in our quarterly results, but I can say that we've had strong movement.
All right, just getting to your financials, have you turned EBITDA positive in the skills and the careers group business segment yet?
It's likely that we will turn positive, EBITDA positive in our skills business. We've had, as I've mentioned before, headwinds specifically with respect to India. I think we will see a positive turn because we are seeing some green shoots in that business, specifically with respect to our Stack Root initiative as well as our talent pipeline as a service initiative. So both of these initiatives are doing well, and on the back of these initiatives as well as strong enrollments, we feel that as we get closer towards the end of the year, we'll start seeing profitability in India as well. Our business outside of India is currently positive from a skills and career perspective. So overall, I feel we should be seeing some positive movement at SNC.
Okay. What about the debt on your books? That went up on a quarter-on-quarter basis in Q1. Would you look to bring it down? And also your return on capital employed, which is at 11.7%. Is that comfortable, or would you like to up it?
Our debt did go up in the past 3-4 months, but I think there was an artificial delay. As you might recall, we acquired Eagle Productivity Solutions in January, and so from a normal point of view, our net debt should have gone up at the end of Q4 or early Q1. However, we had some strong collections in our Q4, and therefore the normal debt levels were not reflected in Q4. They did get reflected at the end of Q1, and like you pointed out, you saw an increase in the net debt level. We feel that some of that will go down. It will go down to a more natural number, which will be in the mid-70s as we close out.
All right. What about, what's your target in terms of the ROCE number?
I think that's a more long-term goal. We expect to substantially improve the return on capital employed, predominantly because the capital employed in our corporate learning business is much lower than the rest of the business. And given that the corporate learning business is about 70% of the total business. Over time, we see the ROCE number improve quite substantially. Also, especially as the SNC business will start growing towards the end of this year, I think these two things combined will result into improved ROCE from a long-term perspective.
Okay, just one final question then. You had planned a ramp down of the government school business. How is that progressing, and after adjusting for this, what kind of a revenue growth can be expected?
So the planned ramp down in the government school business is going as planned. I think we are pretty much done with the contracts. We have a long tail that will continue with us for the next couple of quarters, but by and large we have completed the projects that we had started, and we are in the close down phase of those projects. So you will not see the government schools business as a line item as we look at the next fiscal year. With respect to private schools business, the high season for that business is quarter four, and at this point in time we are preparing to achieve a high and a strong Q4, which will result into reasonably attractive growth. So it's still a little early to forecast what the overall growth might be, but like I pointed out, we are working hard to ensure that we have a strong Q4.
Okay, thanks so much, sir, for joining in and filling us in with all those details. The market's at the low point of the day, but on that note, we'll wrap up on Chartbusters. You stay with us. Trading Hour comes up next.